I'm quite capable of filling that medi-dose what's-her-name myself.
After the mess you made of it last week, if I hadn't had a look at it on Wednesday, you would have been dead by Friday.
Well, at least I wouldn't have had to suffer your moaning anymore.
Right. I'm off. I shall be back by lunchtime. If not, don't shout at the Meals on Wheels lady again. And don't forget to take your tablets. Sutures.
Katrina, I thought I asked you to dress the tree with the decorations I gave you.
Well, I thought dealing with the patients was a better use of my time, but if you'd prefer...
Yes, I'd like it done by the end of the morning, please. And remember, they are Austrian, they are wooden and very delicate. Be careful.
As if I haven't got enough to do with my time.
Time to imbibe the Christmas spirit, Katrina.
Only if it's vodka.
Morning.
Hi. Just wanted to say thanks for listening yesterday.
Oh, that's okay. Anytime.
Christmas. Families, who needs me?
Tell me about it.
I think it's a vast improvement.
Absolutely.
Christmas is about fun and frolics, not Dickensian nightmares living in a workhouse or eating gruel.
His face is gonna be a picture.
Ready?
Oh, yes.
All right, mate.
Okay.
Did you do that?
What?
The lights. I didn't tell you to put the lights on the tree. It's spoiling the whole effect.
Oh, I don't know.
Can you take them off now?
Oh, I don't think so.
Is there a problem?
There's nothing I can't handle, Helen, thank you. Now, are you going to take the lights off or not?
Now, hold on. Take the lights off.
Did you put them on?
Yes, and I think they look fantastic.
They've ruined it. I wanted something traditional, something tasteful.
Something boring. You can't have your own way with everything.
No, we all agreed. We would have a traditional tree with traditional trimmings.
No, you agreed, then railroaded everyone else. I don't know why you're so uptight.
Isn't this something that should be continued in private?
How can we tell him?
We have to. You can't go on creeping around like a teenager, however attractive I might find the idea.
You make me feel like a teenager.
And that's why we have to tell him.
His heart. He's very weak.
I know. But we've lost too many years to let this opportunity slip by.
Rose.
He's going to be hurt. But he's going to be hurt even more if he finds out later rather than sooner.
Mr. Williams?
Yeah.
nonsense.
I can get up myself. Thank you very much. I tripped over this. Haven't you not heard of the Health and Safety at Work Act?
I'm very sorry, Mr. Vincent. Are you all right? You seem very breathless.
I want to see Dr. Hamada. Now.
I thought I told you to take it easy.
I just went out for a walk and came over breathless, had to sit down. And then I got a bit of a twinge. And so I thought best to come and see you. That's all.
Are you sure that was all?
Yeah.
Arthur, a gentle stroll in the park shouldn't have left you in this state. My psychologist friends would call that overspill. Usually indicative of anxiety beneath a calm exterior. What's worrying you?
Well, if it hadn't been for that blasted toy car, I just want to get home. I don't want to miss the Meals on Wheels lady.
Nearly done. Your ankles are looking a bit swollen. Are you taking your medication?
Well, I may have missed a few doses. But Irvin's got me one of those Medicare containers. I shouldn't miss any more from now on.
Good. I don't need to tell you again how important it is not to exert yourself physically beyond a sensible level. Your heart has been severely weakened by your past heart attacks. The medication will help, but it can only do so much. The rest is up to you. And rest is the operative word. All done. Will you come and see me again in a week?
Yes.
How are you getting back?
Oh, I was walking.
I'll call you a taxi.
I think these would look better on your tree at home.
And I think this would look better on a bonfire.
See, I told you I wouldn't be long.
Did you think I wouldn't find out?
What?
Rose. How could you?
This is ridiculous.
Well, that's the worst of it. I could get the vacuum cleaner.
Oh, thanks.
Can you get that?
Yeah.
Hello, Riverside. Speaking. Hi, Irvin. What? You had a fall. Irvin, the only fall Arthur has had is onto someone's fist. Show me your knuckles. I can't believe you two have been fighting. For heaven's sake, what's going on?
I was defending myself.
He's joking, right? Are you insane? Are you trying to kill yourself? Irvin, you of all people should know better. You know how delicate Arthur's situation is. I know it can't be easy for you living together, but physical violence.
It doesn't matter how often I hit him if he isn't taking his tablets, does it?
Oh, Arthur, you must take these. You know how important they are.
This is getting beyond a joke.
I'm going to have to start getting my manicurist to bill the surgery at this rate.
Since Maximum away, Mark's been impossible. Jude, you're going to have to sort them out before hell breaks loose.
I know. But will they listen to me?
Well, they better do, or else I'll stick them both on the tree like fairies.
Dr. Hamada, please wait.
If this is another excuse for fighting with your very sick brother, quite frankly...
It isn't an excuse, but it might be an explanation.
Go on.
For half a century, Arthur and I were in love with the same woman. She was everything to us. We fought then too. But when we finished fighting, she'd gone. Arthur and I didn't speak for 10 years. Now she's back. Before, she couldn't choose. That's what drove her away in the first place. But this time, she's chosen.
me.
So you remember my name, then?
What are you doing here?
You're going to keep me standing out here all day?
No, of course not. Come in.
Where's Erwin?
You mean he's not here? Getting his feet further under the table? I don't know where he is, and I don't care.
I saw you with him this morning. If I'd known what he was doing, I'd have... I didn't even know you were back in Leatherbridge.
I've been back for years. After Harold died...
Did I mean nothing to you?
No, of course.
Then why... Why didn't you tell me you were back?
You're hard. You must rest.
You sound like my doctor. I know what I can do and what I can't. Why does everybody think they know what's best for me and my heart? I'm here because of my heart. Don't you understand? I love you, Rose. I've never stopped loving you. I can't just let you go off with Erwin. Not now.
Hiya.
Good afternoon.
Very good, very formal. Don't forget you're taking me out tonight.
How could I forget?
I'd like to see Dr. Hamada, please.
Oh, well, you're a bit early for afternoon surgery.
If you tell her it's about Arthur Vincent, I think she'll see me.
Okay.
Thank you for seeing me at such short notice. It's about Arthur. He's been to see me.
How was he?
Breathless, in pain, I think. I put him in a taxi. There was no way he could walk home in that state.
You know that I can't discuss his health with you. If that's why you've come here, then I'm sorry.
It's really about my relationship with Erwin and its consequences that I want to discuss with you. We have to tell Arthur that Erwin is coming to live with me.
Oh, I see. Well, that seems only fair.
I couldn't tell him. I was too scared. His face, I couldn't. He was already so upset.
How can this still be an issue after 50 years?
Neither of them married. I blame myself. Oh, I know I'm not much to look at now, but in my day...
I didn't mean to.
No, it's all right. You're not the first. You should have seen my daughter's face when I told her. A new relationship at my age. I've never seen such a thoroughly complete look of disgust in my life. And I'm sure the effect it will have on Arthur will be just as devastating. We are afraid it will break his heart in more ways than one.
Why have you come to see me?
Erwin says that Arthur has really taken to you. Usually he does nothing but complain about doctors. But he listens to you.
Oh, he doesn't at the moment.
He respects you, Dr. Hamada. I've come here to ask you to tell Arthur that Erwin and I are going to live together.
Hiya. Is your lunch okay?
You're wearing your Jude wants to talk face. You're not interested in my lunch at all.
Yeah. This thing with Mark. It's not you, is it? I mean, it's not your style. If Kate and Matt come back from holiday to find the place like a war zone, what are they going to think?
I know. It's just he makes me so competitive.
Competitive? Sometimes I think you need a referee.
I know it's stupid, but...
Come on, Helen. Someone's going to make the first move.
I had made up my mind that Erwin was to be the one. But... This letter turned my world upside down. You think that everything is certain, and then... I ache for you. When I'm apart from you, my heart is crushed. It is as if there is a storm gathering in my chest, and that my love for you is going to burst forth in a torrent of thunder and lightning. The hours we have spent together are the sweetest memories I have.
That's beautiful.
How could I stay after that? What right had I to choose either? I left, went to Manchester, married within a year. I'm not going to make the same mistake again. But there's still Arthur to be considered. I know I shouldn't be asking you, but please, could you reconsider?
I don't think Mark's capable of making the first move at the moment.
Oh?
Well, he's having a bit of a tough time. Why don't you try cutting him some slack?
Me cut him some slack?
Yeah, have a word with him and sort this out. You know it makes sense.
You're right, of course.
So you'll speak to him?
Yes. I'll have it sorted by close of business today. Mark.
Yes?
I've been thinking, this situation, it's intolerable.
I have to agree with you there.
I don't want to start apportioning blame, but, well, there's clearly a problem between us.
I'm all ears.
Oh, come on in.
I've come for some advice.
From me?
Well, unless there's somebody under the couch, yes.
Yeah, but why me? Why not from Mark or Helen?
Well, you know why not Mark. He never thinks anything I do is right. And Helen, she's...
Yeah, I know. Formidable.
I was going to say imposing.
And that too.
No. It's one of my patients, Arthur Vincent. He's late 70s, heart failure. He's had a long-standing falling out with his brother, over 50 years.
Well, that's a long time.
Yeah.
Don't tell me it's over a woman.
Yeah.
And she's very rich or very beautiful or preferably both.
Stop it, you dreadful cynic. This is love, the real thing. No, Rose, the woman, she's surfaced again and she's preparing to up sticks with the brother. Now, Arthur knows that the relationship is back on, but not that the brother, he's the main carer, is about to go. Their dilemma is how to tell Arthur without getting him worked up into a heart-threatening frenzy.
And Arthur's the jealous type?
Yeah, I mean, he and Irvin, that's the brother, they've already come to blows. And Rose came to visit me today to ask me if I would break the news to Arthur.
And that's a tricky situation.
But what would you do?
There you are. There's a phone call for you.
Yes?
It's Arthur Vincent. He's in a right state, smashing the place up.
Well, I must admit, this is most unexpected. But I have to agree with you, things have gotten silly. This business with the tree.
Exactly, just the point I'm trying to make.
And I can understand your desire to smooth things out, especially before Matt gets back. I appreciate you coming to see me about it. I certainly didn't expect that. No. I'd just like to let you know, your apology means a lot to me.
Arthur, stop it! Calm down!
I don't want to stop here. I don't want to look at it.
Oh, Arthur, if you don't stop, you'll have a heart attack and you will die. Do you hear what I'm saying?
He's at Rose's house now.
You've got to stay calm. Come inside and sit down.
No!
Well, no, stand still then.
I knew she'd be back one day, but I never knew it would be like this.
Arthur, there's nothing you can do about it. You're a sick man. You've got to think about your health. Yeah. And after 50 years, don't you think you could let it go a bit?
And let him go off with the only woman I've ever loved? No! But you're right. There is nothing I can do, not here. I'm going up there.
Arthur! Arthur! You can't do this.
D-
get out of my way.
No.
I'm going to Rose's house and you're not going to stop me.
I know. Get in the car, I'll take you.
Hiya. So, how did it go with Mark?
It didn't.
You didn't talk to him?
I did. It just didn't go to plan. He never behaves the way you expect. I went in there to sort it out, call a truce, and he had the cheek to thank me for my apology.
Oh.
You know, I've dealt with clashes of personality before, but nothing like this. He unnerves me. I've actually been sitting here asking myself, is it me? Is it my problem? Can you believe it? I know. Ridiculous.
Skulking about, thinking I wouldn't find out. Or maybe you thought I'd go quietly off into the sunset. Or were you hoping I'd quietly die first? Save you the headache of telling me.
Why, you...
Will everyone stop shouting, Arthur?
Why, please? Irvin? When you left, you couldn't choose between us. I suppose the prospects were better with him, is that it? No dodgy ticker.
I love Irvin.
You loved me.
There'll always be a place in my heart for you. Don't let jealousy destroy it all now. You've wasted too many years to it already. Why can't you be happy for us?
I've hated him for 50 years for driving you away from me.
It wasn't Irvin who drove me away. It was you, you silly fool. I'd already made up my mind to choose Irvin, and then came your letter. After that, I couldn't decide.
Letter.
Okay, Arthur, time to be sensible. Sit down and let me check you over.
What letter?
Arthur sent me a letter telling me how deeply he loved me. I couldn't cope. I left.
Show me. No!
Call an ambulance. Rose, I said call an ambulance.
Smile the pie face.
It's time we talked about where this is going.
Well, I know where I'd like it to be going. Tonight, at least.
I just want to make sure it's right.
Well, you know what you can do to make it right for me?
Stop the double entendre, please. I'm trying to have a serious conversation with you at the moment.
So am I. We've been seeing each other for a while now. Don't you think it's time that we moved on to a more physical plane?
That's just the point. Is it time?
When will they let us be with him?
Soon, I'm sure.
Thank you for all you did. Do you think he'll be all right?
It's hard to tell. Strokes and the damage that they cause can be difficult to predict. But once the results of the brain scan are known, they'll have a better idea.
He wouldn't be here now if you hadn't given him the letter.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. It was just words on a page.
Irvin's words.
What?
Irvin wrote the letter, and he never sent it. He was scared it would frighten you away. I took it from his room and I read it. How could I match feelings like that? He was always a clever one with words. I copied the letter into my own hand and I sent it, thinking it would make you change your mind and choose me. But he was right all along. It did drive you away. Because of my jealousy, I've ruined everything. I'm sorry.
I could have been with Irvin all the time.
Faith, wait! Look, this isn't going to solve anything.
When are you going to lighten up and have some fun?
Sometimes I feel like this relationship's gone through a time warp. Mr. Darcy, to see you here, Mum. He's brought you a handkerchief. Ooh, what a devil. It's the 21st century, Ben.
No, I'm not like that at all.
Prove it.
Prove what?
Here. Now. Prove to me what a red-blooded 21st century guy you really are.
Why does sex have to be your primary concern? I'm trying to find out what's going on, not have some sordid sexual liaison in a car park.
It can be winter all around me. Snow, hail, rain. But when I'm with you, it is as if endless summer has blossomed in my heart. I look at you, and you are perfect. No amount of time can change that. In 50, 100, 1,000 years, if I could be there to dream, I would dream of you.
Get off speaking to me like that. Who died and left you in charge of managing relationships?
Look, hang on a minute.
No, you shut up. It's my turn now. What is it with you? Did you get a kick out of leading me on or something?
Leading you on?
That's what I said. There's a word for men like you and it isn't a complimentary one. If you just wanted to be friends, you should have said something sooner.
Faith!
Don't waste my time. We're finished.